我觉得我个人还是喜欢一个比较小的一个空间，由我自己来打理它。
我个人认为传统的书店向现代书店转型势不可挡，未来的书店是后书店时代。
我是一个小众书店，就是我们不做标准化，
有些书真的就一步卖不掉，以后第二步都没有。
Molly, Chen Xiaohua, and Jiang Xun are book lovers from three different cities. Each of them owns a space for books. Though physical bookstores face an increasingly challenging commercial environment, these book lovers are determined to cling on to their dreams. Mali opens his bookstore for business at 12 o'clock every day. It's late in the day to start trading, but it's what he's been doing for over 10 years now. Standing at a corner of the Culture Lane in Kunming, Mali's Wheatfield bookstore doesn't look much, but it's regarded as one of the best small bookstores in China.
麦田书店非常小，差不多就17平方左右，到现在为止是15年，自己在手。
你要看什么书啊？
从选书、卖书、打理这个书店
也可以，还有一本嘛。
所有的书籍虽然我没有分类，但我几秒钟我就知道它在哪里。这就是一个人的书店。
Ma Li says that his bookstore is like the city of Kunming. Here, business is run at a leisurely pace. But life wasn't always like that for Ma Li. Before he started his bookshop, he worked in the fast-paced world of securities dealing. There was only so much of the daily grind he could stomach. 5 years into his career, he threw it all in to open a bookshop.
2000年的时候，我去了一趟北京。以前北京有一个帆舟书店，也是非常小的一个书店，但是它里边的书籍是我特别喜欢的。帆舟书店的主人是写摇滚乐的一个历史的，有两本书，一个是《灿烂涅槃》，一个是《山花怒放》，对很多国内玩摇滚乐的影响都非常大。对我来说，当时找到那本书的主人的那个店，我都觉得非常的兴奋和高兴。回到昆明，我就想我自己应该开个这种书店，所以我就在2000年左右，终于实现了这个麦田书店的这个一个小书店的诞生。
小说
《卡尔维诺》，
看不见的城市，看一下，他是意大利非常著名的这个作家。
就是有时候，很多人去一个店，他其实想和这个主人在一起聊聊天，在实体书店遇到，人与人或者是人与书的那种相遇，那种是最好的方式。
那就先读这两本吧。
不行，我看不见的城里，他下次来你
没有。好了，没关系，你放心。好，先看这三本吧。
谢谢。
对于现在的这种环境来说，我觉得挺满意的，很快乐。
我送给你的
啊，不要啦。
现在碰到假期非常多，那就是真的是很多朋友他会来了以后呢，就跟你聊天，跟你一起聊书聊音乐。
麦田15周年的一个小礼物，就送给大家，很好听，它里面的音乐，用磁带去还原它，
非常珍贵的礼物。
And Ma Li isn't just the owner of a bookshop. He has another string to his bow as founder and drummer of the band Strange Days. Whenever the shop's closed, you can be sure that Ma Li is busy rehearsing or performing. The bookstore and the band are like two lighthouses in his spiritual world, watching over each other.
这支乐队应该是98、99年正式开始一起出来玩和朋友，但是呢，来来回回我估计有二三十个人，就是来来回回走，又重新和新的朋友认识的，但是现在还在玩，很写，没得啥过呢，对对对对对，就是你自己坚持，别人才会又来。 又重新组建，就像你做一个小书店，你就是每天你都会在这个书店，每周你都会去淘书，才会有一些很好的结果。我觉得我自己淘书最大的还是去批发市场，每个星期必须去一次。
每次来不一定，就是十多本。 或者是要看他的新书多不多，这个是人物传记、历史。Ma
Li's approach to replenishing his stock is a world away from the reliance on large-scale distributors adopted by larger bookstores. His way of doing things is more personal. What interests him will find its way onto the shelves of his shop so others can share in his enthusiasm. Sometimes he wonders whether he should get a larger place or take a different approach to manage the shop. Always the conclusion is the same. He's happy with things the way they are.
一个人的能力它是分大小的，我可能只有这么大的一个能力去把握我这个理想。你能在这个小的这个里面找到你的理想和你的现实所存在的东西，这个事情也在鼓励你用最大的方式去追求你自己的一个小的一个梦想。 开书店现在也成为我的，就是我的工作吧，但也是我生活中最重要的一部分。我最喜欢就是和这个书店一起变化。Bookstores
are vital to the spiritual well-being of a city. In many cases, they only exist because of the determination of a small group of people to cling on to their dreams. It's not just book lovers turned small businessmen like Ma Li. Another breed of book-loving entrepreneur is determined to transform the very concept of the traditional bookstore. The Libraire Avant-Garde, situated in Nanjing, was converted from an underground car park. It was once showcased on the BBC's as one of the top 10 of the world's most beautiful bookshops. This bookstore is not only the paradise of books in the heart of many book lovers, but also a Nanjing cultural landmark.
一定要强调我们的常备书、小众书、日借，这个偏门冷门的书，这就是先锋，你别人抢不了的。
In his 20 years in the business, Qian Xiaohua has seen the growth of online book sales and the arrival of the e-book. And they've taught Qian a valuable lesson. If businesses like his are to survive, constant innovation is the key. Whether it's theming the shop or making it into a hub for cultural events and creative products, standing still is not an option. As far as Qian Xiaohua is concerned, far from being in decline, the physical bookstores in China has entered an era of creative transformation. So confident is he in his vision of the 21st century bookstore, that he's even begun to branch out into the countryside. The Bishan bookshop is the eighth branch. While the others have stuck to tried and tested urban locations, this is the first one catering for rural readers. Hidden away in idyllic Yi County, this bookstore maintains the style of ancient Huizhou architecture. It's a bold move, and there have been plenty of doubters and naysayers. Despite these doubts, Qian Xiaohua did not flinch. To make the bookstore more localized, he invited Wang Shouchang, former village director, to help him run the bookstore. In 2014, Bishan Bookshop opened, quickly becoming a lively gathering place for the villagers in their leisure time. It's also become the local public library.
我离家里不远，两条一条巷弄一串就到了。我就是劳动忙呢，家里有事啊，我都要到这里转转。我不看书，都要转转，喜欢到这个地方。这里的职工啊、员工啊，他们都好，都对我好。我也想来看看，哎，婆婆啊，热闹热闹，人多热闹，看看。我就是喜欢看书，从小就看书，但是没买过书，不买书，买书还要花经济哎。因为我是农民家的孩子，我知道农村最需要的就是文化，最需要的就是公共空间。有的很多的乡村过去都有千年的夙愿，但实质性的消失已尽。就是我们到乡村去做这样一件事情，我觉得更多的是以文化引领的乡村复兴，激活乡村的创造力和生产力。
Not long after the Bishan Bookshop opened, it became popular online due to its unique beauty and setting. People hailed it the most beautiful rural bookstore in China. It even attracts tourists to the village. So, much to the surprise of the doubters, the shop began to turn a profit. The survival of the Bishan bookshop looks assured. Twenty years ago, Qian Xiaohua made the lone journey from the countryside to the city. Now, with his bookshop, he's making the opposite journey, more passionate than ever, his faith in his dream renewed.
I think the 不是要创造概念，而是要创造价值。
Opening a bookstore in a place like this has always been Qian Xiaohua's dream. He's determined to open even more theme bookshops in rural areas. Making the dream a reality is a challenge all of these bookish entrepreneurs have had to face. It's a tricky task to accomplish. But creating shops based around their personal styles, tastes, and preferences has paid off. These are unique shops that stand out in a competitive marketplace. Jiang Xun is the founder of the Model Bookstore. As a bookworm, he has a collection of nearly 100,000 books. The Model Bookstore is more than just Jiang Xun's shop. It's also his laboratory, the place where he hopes to discover the secret formula for the bookstore of the future. What's striking about the books sold in Model Bookstore is how uncommon they are. From highbrow art books to poetry collections independently published by the bookstore itself, from signed copies by famous authors to hand-stitched ancient volumes, every book here is an expression of Jiang Xun's passion and ingenuity.
This area is a special feature of our bookstore. It is mainly concentrated on the world's various bookstores, including our different bookstores that have received famous handwritten books. Many of them are unique to our bookstore. For example,
Jiang Xun chose to open his bookstore on the Yangmeizhu Street near Tianmen because of a book he'd bought.
This book is from the auction house's high price taken. 清末民国间的一个手抄本的书目，它记载了杨梅竹斜街的历史。当时福晋书社是清云阁内的一个最大的一个书商，它内部自己印的一本，它所售卖的书目的一个册子，记载很详细。你看，《静夜堂诗集》，海宁《杂身行》的，乾隆《经写课本》这主旨的《杂身行》啊，是金庸的曾祖父吧。 最初印本就是一本宽大写的宽大，这几载，12本洋50元，50大洋啊，很贵了。但现在也是很贵的，要出印本现在也是卖的很贵，而且出全了很难。我觉得这本书应该归还到这条街上，啊，属于杨梅竹斜街，它不应该属于我个人的。
There were lots of bookshops in Yangmeizhu Street during the early Republic of China period, such as the World Bookshop, Zhongzheng Bookshop, Kaiming Bookshop. By far, it was the most important street in the publishing business. In 2014, Jiang Xun chanced upon Yangmeizhu Street by accident. Not only had it retained its original architectural style, but was also full of vitality. Then the idea struck him. Why not open a bookstore here? In September 2014, Model Bookstore opened at number 31 Yangmeizhu Street. At last, the once familiar musty smell of books was back. Like many others, Jiang Xun founded the Model Bookstore because of his deep affection for books. However, he understands that the most urgent task is to figure out how to make sure his bookshop stays alive as a going concern.
Because I'm a small bookstore, for example, my books, every book has to be through my eyes. Basically, it's all about me escaping, even just one book. I love these books, so I can attract readers to me. 一位老先生，因为他父亲可能是一个外交家，啊，所以就是在原来可能拥有了一些书，啊，后来都遗失了，所以他要把这个之前他在小说看的书，现在能想起来再买回来。恰恰我们书店里有好多他小说记忆的书，哎，这种我觉得也是一个让我们重拾阅读，他重拾记忆，他要把那小说的记忆买回来。而我觉得这个也是人生的一个乐趣吧。
These carefully selected books have attracted many different groups of readers to the bookstore. Being niche is exactly what Jiang Xuan wants his bookshop to be. The model bookstore also has its own imprint, Thread-Bound Books. This is just the sort of venture that Jiang Xuan hopes will help the model bookstore stand out in the market so it can survive and thrive.
古意今新，我们继承它，把小说和诗集变成古代的雕版。它结合了一个是刻工的智慧，还有我们这个作家的智慧，把古代的元素包装进去，它就是一个产品，一个新型的文创产品。
It was a brilliantly simple idea that grew out of his long obsession with ancient woodblock printing, to use this ancient craft to create bespoke editions of modern novels and poetry collections. After more than a decade collecting them, he now has more than 30,000 woodblocks.
This 块书版就是民国期间蒋汝昭他那个得到这个宋版之后就长窗粤语这个宋版书他方刻的。这个草创女的原版，所以我们就用这个版的字体，复刻了北岛先生，还有西川，包括目前做的是这个余光中的诗集，都用这个南宋的字体来翻刻宋版。
雕版只是一个更小众的，因为它是一个书籍印刷的母体，我们新刻雕版只是说在继承古代。我是希望把它推广下去，给更多优秀的，文人作家来用雕版刻书。
In a building whose architecture represents a blend of East and West, and which was built in the period of the Republic of China.The sound of printing and engraving is the very pulse of the model bookstore, proof that it is alive and kicking. It's a vivid demonstration that, despite the tremendous technological advances that are reshaping the world of publishing and bookselling,As long as entrepreneurs have the determination to make their dreams a reality and the vision to revamp the physical bookstore, this is a time-honored trade that has a glittering future ahead of it.